Today we're going to find out who cares about Gary. She says, I care. Karen Freeman Wilson, mural candidate, will be joining us in the living room in just a second. Also, Tawana Parker, she will be playing her flute and telling us what she has coming up for as plays and CDs is concerned. But before we begin the show, I want to talk about cell phones, you guys. I'm going to talk about a little bit about cell phones. See, my grandmother, she's about 80,000 years old, you guys. And her phone in her house, her landline, is that same phone that you put in 1, 2, 3. And so just this past Monday, she bought an iPhone, right? Major upgrade, wouldn't you say? So she's calling me every 5 minutes asking, okay, how do I dial the numbers? How do I call out? How do I text? What's a text message? What's the internet? I'm like, Granny, just take the phone back, stick to your, no, but I want to be savvy and hang with y'all, text, Facebook, and she don't know anything about it. But that's old folks. You know, I just want to say, you know, stick with your comfort zone. The landline phones is what you need to do. And when we come back from commercial, Karen Freeman Wilson will be joining us in the living room.
Did you know that the average Social Security benefit is only $780 a month?
I didn't know that.
Did you know that most people will spend 20 years in retirement?
I didn't know that.
Did you know that a 40-year-old who saves $20 a week can have $75,000 when they retire?
I didn't know that.
There's a lot you might not know. To get free information about savings, visit our website or call this number.
I know what to do now.
We're back with more In Your House with Antoine Clemens. I'm joined at this time with mayoral candidate Karen Freeman Wilson. How are you doing?
How are you?
All right.
It's great to be here.
Definitely is an honor for you to join me in the living room today. You are running for mayor of the city of Gary currently.
I am.
Great. And before we talk about your plans and what your the reasons of running, can you give us some early beginnings?
Sure. Well, I'm a product of Gary, the mm-hmm. Gary Public School System. I was blessed enough to attend Harvard College and Harvard University in Cambridge, Massachusetts, as well as Harvard Law School.
Okay.
After graduating from law school, I returned to Gary and began working in the Lake County Prosecutor's Office as a deputy prosecutor.
Okay.
I soon began being a public defender, and shortly, about 3 months after I started, I got a call from then-Governor Evan Bayh to come down to Indianapolis and head up the Indiana Civil Rights Commission.
Wow.
I did that for a few years, and Judge Chuck Graddick resigned. And when he resigned, Governor Bayh appointed me to fulfill his unexpired term.
Wow.
I then ran 2 times and was elected as judge of the city of Gary.
Yeah.
After that, I went back to Indianapolis as the Indiana Attorney General. And after I left the Indiana Attorney General's office, I went to Washington and headed up a not-for-profit called the National Association for Drug Court Professionals.
Okay.
And I actually still am a national drug court advocate to this day. And I've also been an attorney practicing in this community for 25 years.
Wow, that's a lot.
Yeah, it is.
Just to name a few, huh?
Yeah, just to name a few things.
Great. So you've been doing some great leadership roles and from not only in Gary, but state-wise and also national-wise. So that does say a lot about what you're doing here. But again, you're running for mayor of the city of Gary.
I am.
What inspired you to run for mayor?
Well, you know, having had the opportunity to travel to so many cities and see them prosper and then to return home very often and see the challenges that we have, mm-hmm. I've been blessed enough to have experience, to have the education, and to just see how things work well. And I'd like to bring that expertise and that education to the city of Gary, to the mayor's office.
Mm-hmm. And in sitting in that mayor's seat, what are some of the what do you think you can change from the previous administration?
Well, you know, my focus during the campaign and my focus mm-hmm. as mayor would be four issues. One is public safety, the other is education, the other is jobs or economic development, and then transparent government. I always refer to it as government as a service industry. We often think of hotels, we think of restaurants as being in the service industry. It's my position that government is also part of the service industry.
Great. So you just named some key points here: public safety, education, economic development. If you can hit on your public safety plans.
Well, you know, my public safety plan is to use all of our resources at every level of government, local, county, federal, state law enforcement officers, as well as to interface with the state and federal prosecutor and to really set a standard or at least indicate to the judiciary what level of behavior we want to see enforced in the city of Gary. By doing that, I think that we're able to send a message to folks who really don't abide by the law that Gary is off limits for criminals. At the same time, we're not just looking to put everybody in jail. We want to provide alternatives to incarceration where appropriate. But at the end of the day, we just want to establish a standard of law-abiding behavior so that if something occurs, a murder or other violent crime, to everyone, that's the exception rather than the rule.
So your education is... Speaking of education, we know now downstate that the state senate has passed all these educational bills, and it's really putting the school district, not only in our district, but in other districts and surrounding areas in a bind. You can elaborate a little bit on that area?
Well, you know, a lot of people say, well, the mayor really doesn't have any direct control over education because the mayor doesn't hire the superintendent and doesn't have an appointee or a person on the school board. My position is, one, you're not just talking about the Gary schools. You're talking about Lake Ridge schools. You're talking about public charter schools, private schools, universities, trade schools. And you don't have to control something to influence it.
Right.
So my position for influencing education would be to work with all providers of education at every level to determine how we can work together. So perhaps with the school systems, it's to help them to shore up or to improve their security off campus, on campus, so that everybody feels safe, so that everyone is not concerned about traveling to and from school. Perhaps it's helping them to develop environmental curricula so that their students can go out into the workforce after graduation and perhaps get a job in the recycling industry or in the green construction industry. Or perhaps it's just helping them to engage parents by creating a partnership between the faith community, between schools, and between the mayor's office to get them to mentor parents so that they can be involved in their children's education.
Well, such a large demographic, and you mentioned economic development. What plans do you have in place to bring jobs and bring structure in our business community tax base here in the city of Gary?
Well, you know, my approach to economic development is going to be to build on our existing resources. And when I think about that, I think about the highways. We're in the middle of four major highways, two major railways, and I'm talking about at the national level. We have three national trucking companies right here in the city of Gary, as well as access to a waterway that goes all the way to the Gulf of Mexico in the port of Indiana, not to mention our airport. And so my position is that we should build on that, and I would create an intermodal facility that would allow the trains to come in, unload, the trucks to go in and either transport that cargo over to the airport, to the port of Indiana, or along all of the highways that come through Gary. They could transport things to California, to New York, and points in between, to Minnesota, to as far south as Alabama, because we're in the midst of the in the country. And that would create a variety of jobs, warehouse jobs. It would also require construction for the building of the facility, for the building of warehouses. You would see forklift operator jobs, truck driving jobs. There would be a variety of jobs that would be created through the intermodal facility.
All right. The state has been talking about the state and also the county government that's pushing Gary into a bind of submission, or in the case Senate Bill 105, that's the bankruptcy law for government entities to be able to file bankruptcy. And recently this year we had our current mayor, Mayor Clay, on the show to talk about Senate Bill 105 and the different things of the city being pushed into submission. From just my opinion, I won't talk about the opinions that was on the show, but the opinion of what's being shown, that state is really trying to back the city into submission. How can you, win that seat as mayor, can force or be the mouthpiece for the city to get them to for the state and county government to help us instead of take from us?
Well, first and foremost, a mayor is an advocate. Mm-hmm. And as an advocate, I have to be willing to stand up for the residents of Gary, mm-hmm. as I've done before for individual clients and for the city. But more importantly, Senate Bill 105 is basically a bankruptcy bill for municipalities. Mm-hmm. And my position on the bill has always been that you only have to file bankruptcy when your assets are outweighed by your liabilities. Right. Gary has a wealth of assets, our waterfront, our airport, our location. Mm-hmm. All of those are assets for us as a community. The problem with us is not that we don't have the assets, it's simply that the assets have been underdeveloped. And so as mayor, my job, I think, is to prevent bankruptcy and to help to develop those assets so that we can increase our assessed valuation as a community.
Our current situation, do you feel that we are in a situation to file bankruptcy, or are we in a turnaround stage?
I think we're in a turnaround stage. Mm-hmm. I think certainly we're going to have to reduce some of our expenses. I think we're going to have to generate additional revenue. I have ideas of doing that through code enforcement and through a variety of other ways, but I'm very optimistic and at the same time, I'm realistic that it's going to be very difficult, but I think it can be done, and I think it can be done without us having to go into the municipal bankruptcy phase.
Great. Well, we looked and seeked to our Facebook audience and asked them to send in a question, and most of our youth of the city of Gary have sent out questions. The youth community, I'll say,
sure.
I sent out a question, and the question that stands out: what can you do if you come in as mayor, if you win the election, to bring some jobs for the youth or some youth programs? Our parks, they say, is in not in good condition. How can you bring some youth projects to the city?
Well, the intermodal facility that I talked about earlier that would lead to greater development at the airport, additional warehousing. Those opportunities, those are jobs for the youth and jobs for all residents mm-hmm. of Gary. In addition, we are looking to expand on the Marquette Park development that is already underway on the west side of our lakefront, mm-hmm. As well as to look at development on the west side of the lake. Mm-hmm. As it relates to recreation, I envision a Marquette Park that rivals Navy Pier.
Okay.
And we all run over to Navy Pier, and I always tell people, the same lake
exactly.
that is on Navy Pier
it's
is right here.
Here
in Gary. Mm-hmm. So we just need to develop opportunities there, recreation, restaurants, enjoyment. In addition to that, I know that our parks are in bad shape. We have the benefit of having a number of universities here with both parks and recreation programs, as well as horticultural programs. We need to take advantage of those students who are in those programs as interns for our parks to improve the appearance of our parks, to improve the programming at our parks, and to give our young people and our seniors an opportunity to enjoy our parks, our families.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about Mayor Clay. He and several weeks ago, or say last month, he stepped down, suspended his campaign due to illnesses.
Sure.
And he said publicly that he's going to endorse you because he feels that you will carry out the vision of what the city, you're the best leader, the next leader to take over, to take the city into the future. And paper said, and different candidates stated that he endorsed you because you were different, just different issues that I won't display on the show.
Sure.
But how did you feel about Mayor Clayton?